There's a couple different ways that you can pay for a solar electric system. The easiest one is to pay in cash. That's pretty straightforward. You have money, you find an installer, you pay them money. It's also going to be the most financially beneficial system because you don't have to pay interest expense. You'll be able to take advantage of any incentives like federal tax credits or any state, local, or utility incentives. The next best way to pay for it is loans, and there are a lot of home equity loans that are low interest. There are also many different providers of loans specifically for solar electric systems. They're also usually relatively low interest. Beware, there are some loans out there that are higher interest, and those are going to have a negative impact on your financial return to the system. With loans, obviously you have to pay interest back, so that's going to reduce that financial benefit of the system. But if you get a low interest loan, it's pretty minimal impact. The other two types are called third-party financing. There's two types of third-party financing. There's leases and PPAs, or power purchase agreements. And these are simply financial packages where you're going to pay a certain amount each month for using the solar array. With a lease, you're paying for the use of the equipment. So the equipment's installed in your house, another party, a third party, owns the system, and you're paying them a monthly fee to use the equipment. So you're getting whatever power is generated by that system. And that may be a lot or not much at all, depending on the time of year and how well the system is operating. Usually with a lease, there is some type of service requirement, and there's a production guarantee in that lease, which is really important for a leased system. With a power purchase agreement, it's also a third-party finance system, but instead of paying to use the equipment, you're simply paying for the energy generated by the system. So you're going to pay a per kilowatt hour fee for every kilowatt hour generated by the system. So that monthly fee is going to fluctuate throughout the year depending on the generation of the system. It's also nice with a power purchase agreement because if the system stops operating, you're paying for the energy generated. So if it doesn't generate any energy, you're not going to be paying for that power purchase agreement. Now, leases are fairly common in most regions of the country. Leases have been used in commercial operations for things like printers for years. So it's a type of financing that's very well known. Power purchase agreement is not available in every state because having a power purchase agreement, that third party is essentially becoming an energy generator, almost considered a utility. So they are regulated a little bit more than leases are. Leases and power purchase agreements, since you don't own the system, a third party owns it, they're going to be the ones getting the incentives and tax credits. So leases and power purchase agreements work really well for people who don't have taxable income or for organizations that aren't taxed, like schools and nonprofits. Not always the best financial case for people who pay taxes. Usually a cash purchase or a loan is going to be more financially beneficial than a lease and PPA in those circumstances. But we have a couple different options, kind of meets all needs across the board.